Guys, we're going to talk a little bit about our rowing stroke. So I'm going to get Luca just to start to demonstrate the full stroke. So he's just going to do a few repetitions. Okay, so there's many different phases that we want to break down and have a look at here. We've got the catch phase, the drive phase, the finish, and the recovery. So you can see as Luca's rowing, if you watch the chain, it stays nice and flat as it goes out. So there's virtually no vertical movement up and down. So this is the efficiency of the stroke, okay? We'll also see when he's rowing, we can start to look at his torso position. So as he comes into the catch phase, his torso is here roughly at about 11 o'clock. And then as he drives out into his finish phase, we're looking at the torso being around about 1 o'clock, okay? So we're not moving the torso overly too much, all right? We're trying to get most of the power to come from the legs. We don't want to be in a bad position, shoulder again. So we see this a lot with people reaching forward. And now you look at this, it's more about 10 o'clock instead of about 11 o'clock position. So try and think about the clock face with your torso. Try and think that you're moving between the 11 and 1 o'clock as you start to go through the row there, okay? So now let's come in and have a look at the catch. So a normal sort of catch position, you can see he's at 11 o'clock, and this is going to affect the efficiency of the row. So if he's here, he's got a nice long stroke, so now if you want to pull the way out, so you think of that range, he's gone from here all the way to here, whereas if he has a short catch, so come in now and show the short catch position. So this was his good catch, this is his short catch. So now when he rows, he's only got this much, so it's going to affect the efficiency of each stroke. If you've got a short catch, you're going to have to work a lot harder to cover the same distance, okay? Now let's talk about the drive phase. So if he goes from his catch position now and just drives to his finish, okay, this is the drive phase. We'll come back in again. You watch slowly, he's going to go legs first, but then he's going to open the hips a little bit of hips, and then he's going to pull with the arms. So the sequence is important. We want to make sure we've got legs, hips, and arms to generate the power and the efficiency. You can think of it in terms of a clean, okay? So Olympic lifting, from our clean, we're pushing the floor away with the legs, we're extending with the hips, and the arms are the last part of the pull to generate, obviously, the most power. So rowing's very similar to our Olympic lifting in that state. Now, if we have a look at his finish position, so if he comes back into the catch, and this is where he generates his power and he pulls all the way out, and then this is the finish position there, and this is virtually when he's relaxing. So once he's hit this position, it's relaxed. So we talked about this in terms of if you're picking up a weight, if I was to deadlift a weight, and then I was just to drop it. So there's a lot of energy, a lot of power. But then as we go back, it's as if you're just dropping it and relaxing. So it's the ability of the athlete to be able to go from that contractile force to then switching off and being able to hit our recovery. I'll get Luca to do a few strokes again now. So we're going to talk about, here's our drive phase, and then here's our recovery phase. So the drive is about the power. So we think about this, you're pulling out one, and there's a one, two. One, one, two. One, one, two, okay? So if we look at our recovery, it's sort of like a ratio. Our drive phase is the one, recovery is two. So the recovery should always be the longest part of the stroke, okay? And we should be slowing this down. We shouldn't be trying to race back in too quickly. Think about the rower as a flywheel. When you pull out, the flywheel is spinning really fast. If you come back too quickly, you're just skimming the top of the flywheel, okay? So we want to give the flywheel a chance to slow down. So pull out, and it slows down, rip it, rip it. Start to generate again more efficiency in our rowing stroke. So that ratio is sort of 1-2, and we want to try to find a rhythm. And obviously that depends on the distance that we're rowing, but really try and focus on that just a little bit, okay? And that sort of covers and breaks down the stroke. We talked about the catch, we talked about the drive, the finish, and the recovery. And they're all positions you guys should start to learn and start to master if you want to start to improve the efficiency of your rowing.